Today we're going to be talking about gender equality. We'll be talking about balance for better, looking at balance in the boardroom, in politics, in sport, in the arts, the media, the community in general. So you know the gender pay gap starts with pocket money.
Really?
Yes.
I'll put it on the table because I don't want it to be the elephant in this conversation. There is a disparity between what the AFL players and the AFLW players are being paid.
But what's the whole point of professionalising sport? Like, to stop this problem? I just can't believe... You're the captain of the Cats. Like, this is ridiculous.
We have come a long way in a short time, but I think that has to be the goal in the short term, is that we become full-time athletes so we can have this as our, you know, our only profession.
The way that female sport is judged is the same metrics as male sport. So I actually think there's something wrong with that. The difference that AFLW and women's sport is making to the landscape of Australia is immense.
If it's going to take less than 200 years to achieve pay equality, then we've got to talk about it. And we need men engaged in this conversation.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's no doubt for balance for better. We do need men on the journey as well. I presented about women's football and a man probably in his 70s stood up and said, "Oh, it's never going to be anything. It's not going to be good. It's, you know, it's like watching F grade of the 16 old boys."
I will not be lectured about sexism and misogyny by this man. I will not.
I get a bit frustrated when I see, you know, men sort of clumsily trying to help other men on this issue and say things like, "Oh, imagine if it was your daughter or your sister." And I'm like, imagine if it was you. Yes. Imagine if you were in this scenario. Like, there are structural disincentives to women being able to fully actualise and achieve excellence.
Are you a supporter of quotas?
I am. I remember Joan Kerner once saying that quotas didn't stop merit from rising to the top, they allowed merit to rise to the top. How do the public cope with women being injured and the visuals of that?
People find it quite threatening in some way that to see females get injured.
Terrible scenes for the Melbourne Footy Club. One of their leaders and their veterans, Mel Hickey, is in tears.
It's confronting.
They want to
Somebody has to explain
females.
To these people how menstruation and childbirth work.